I was very healthy, very active. You know, I did a lot of hiking, biking, doing stuff with my kids, getting the diagnosis of stage 3 ovarian cancer. I was pretty sure bad things were gonna happen and I might not survive, so it was scary. I am Mary Catherine Riley. I was diagnosed with ovarian cancer in 2019. I am a mother of 2 children. I'm a 5th grade special education teacher. I had some bloating, going to the bathroom more often. So I had a GYN appointment in June, and I really didn't do anything till then, but I did notice the bloating getting worse. So right away did an ultrasound, an OVA1 test, which is a biomarker for ovarian cancer. And once those came back and they were pretty evident that there was something there, he ordered a CT as well. And that showed that there was a mass in the ovaries. The GYN told me that he was pretty sure I had ovarian cancer. My initial reaction was really devastation. I felt like I was gonna die, probably, because I knew that the statistics for ovarian cancer were not great for survival. The GYN said, I'm gonna refer you to an oncologist, Dr. Thacker. And she was at Washington University and let me know that I would need to have surgery. She did get the diagnosis of stage 3 ovarian cancer. First course of action was on my treatment plan was the surgery, and Dr. Thacker said, I'll try to get everything that I see. So she did that, and unfortunately I did end up having to get the chemotherapy. I did 6 rounds of it. After the chemo, no evidence of disease, everything looked good, but they know that it has a tendency to come back. So they put me on anastrozole, which is an estrogen blocker. After about 3 years of getting CT scans, everything looked pretty good, but they were watching a lymph node. In 2023, was at a point that they could do a biopsy, and it showed that it was a recurrence of the ovarian cancer. So Dr. Thacker said, well, you know, the anastrozole is not working, but we do have a clinical trial study that you can go on, and I think you would be a great candidate for it. I was on the trial for 2 years, and I had a complete response. Being on a clinical trial study has, you know, really shown me that there's so much that goes into the cancer research. There's so many people that are involved, and they're all so very dedicated. When I first was diagnosed with the cancer, my kids were 9 and 16. So, you know, it's been 6 years now. And, you know, it's just kind of been part of the routine as far as just battling the cancer. I love to go hiking. I definitely do yoga, meditation every morning just to kind of get my mind right and stay in the moment. I knew that even though you're fit, even though you do the right things, you know, cancer can be a part of your life and not, you know, you're not exclusive of getting that kind of diagnosis. So, you know, staying active and focusing on those things kind of just helps you through. What I would say to members of Congress and the public in general is just that, you know, funding cancer research is extremely important. You know, I'm living proof, basically, that a trial study and the research helped save my life, and it's gonna be able to, you know, save other people that have the same kind of cancer that didn't have a treatment prior to this research being done. So, you know, having that funding to go towards, you know, the medications that I take, to go towards research for all the different types of cancers that are out there is extremely important.